immediate supervisor. Sin reporting, minsan ang term to, reporting to.
Supervisor.
So, sino yung immediate superior or supervisor? So, for example, kung catechetical director, immediately reporting to whom?
Bishop.
Dito, lalagay mo, bishop. Yung immediate, boss mo, yun ang tinatawag mo. Kalino ka, to whom are you reporting to? That has to be clear. Hindi mo pwedeng, ito pa po, oh. Yan, superior. So, immediate. Okay tayo. Tapos yung isa, normally din, isa pa sabihin nyo, confidential, kailangan lalagay nyo magkano, ha? Siyempre, minsan, hindi salary ang tawag nyo. Let's say, value, stipend, para ano, compensation. Gamitin nyo yung term that is more acceptable to your community. You use the term that is acceptable to your community. So, if you say instead of salary, you want to talk about compensation,
pro bono.
Compensation.
Pro bono.
Honorarium.
Pro bono.
Allowance, whatever that is.
Incentives.
Ah, magkaiba yan. We talk about incentives.
Pro bono.
Salamat okay. Tapos sabi mo, 1 peso. Are we good? And then, malagay niyo po yung muna. O kaya, overall, yung summary. Pwedeng summary or general function. Meaning, in a short paragraph consisting of about 3 to 4 sentences, what is really the main function of the director? Kung ito, director, di ba? We're talking of the director of the catechetical ministry. So in one sentence or two, in a brief paragraph, what is really the function of the catechetical director? Tingnan nyo may kakabili. Sigurado ba kayo? May trabaho kayo. In a sentence or two. Pakisabi nga nyo sa katabi. What is your general function? Sige, may hear from a catechetical director. Kasi sabi, nag-ano? Ako po, director. Sige, director.
Mga director.
Give me your general function as a director. Father.
Supervisor.
Nako, ah, bigat ah. Manage the entire organization. Aba, yung buong organization. Ang sabahan.
Supervise.
Yan, be specific. Hindi yung buong simbahan. Buong organization. Kala ko, director ka lang ng katikete. Kaya yung gusto ko buong simbahan. See? The general, okay. The general description of your function should only capture your scope of work. So you should use specific words, specific scope. So, for example, if you're talking about catechetical, so it means manage, so let's say,
catechetical program,
the diocesan, catechetical programs, and apostolic, well, or apostolic. Yun lang ang pinag-uusapan natin, hindi yung buong simbahan. So you should be very specific with that when you say you manage. So yun yung summary, di ba? One sentence or two. You always start with, okay, job description should always start with behavioral words. No? Meaning it's something that you can observe, something that you can measure. Yan. So the next one should be your specific duties and responsibilities. So that's the next one. Ito na yung mga specifics, right? So when you say specific duties and responsibilities, so how do you now translate concretely managing the diocesan catechetical program? So you now break it up into specific duties and responsibilities. You have to break up that managing. So what do you mean when you say you manage specifically? Oh, you can give me samples. So if we are to break up the function of the catechetical director, what will be these specific duties? Anybody can share?
Give inputs.
Reports directly.
We go into a specific programs. Specific programs.
Okay, give me a verb. That's why I said you start with a specific verb. That is measurable.
Report.
Coordinates.
Coordinates with who? Coordinates with the catechetical director. Ganito din, mayroon akong isang director. I was the one who did the administration manual of the school. No? Kailangan yung duties and responsibilities nyo, may friend. Normally, meron yung ano, meron tong clustering. You cluster those that are related to, kaya nga tinatanong ko sa inyo, managing. No? So, or everything that is related, for example, to planning. Kasi part of what you do is you plan, right? So, lahat ng planning function, lahat ng mga specific duties related to planning, specify nyo. Para related sila, cluster them. No, cluster lahat ng duties related to planning. Cluster all the duties related to? Okay, that's correct. Pagkatapos ng planning, implementation, di ba? So, lahat ng mga work related to implementation or implementing the program. Una, planning the programs. Pangalawa, implementing the programs and activities. Lahat ng mga related doon. Kasi pagka yung isa, sabi mo, reporting. Nag-umpisa ka dito, tapos susunod, coordinate, magulo. Hindi, it's not easy to read, no? But if you're clustering, you can cluster also on the basis of how you, but I am just telling you, if you're the administrator, you have a planning function, you have an implementing function. So what are all those related to implementing? Right? Ano yung planning? For example, if you're really in charge of what? Facilitating. For example, hindi ko ito yung gumagawa. So for example, facilitating the annual planning workshop of the catechetical ministry. So it's a function, you facilitate. Iba naman yung prepare, magkaiba yun. Prepares the annual plan of the catechetical ministry. Iba yung, magkaiba yung dalawa na yun. Do not put two functions in one sentence, one at a time. Iba kasi yung nagpa-facilitate ka, iba yung nagpe-prepare ka ng report.
How about, ma'am, yung recruitment?
Recruitment na?
Facilities.
If that is part of your planning, okay. Hindi dito mo lalagay. Lahat yung related, no? Kasi yung isa, planning general, pwede rin recruit, that is part of the, if that is part of the planning. Okay, so part of the recruitment, pwede yun. Recruits, for example, recruits.
Volunteers.
For?
Is it safe to write at the end of the specific functions and does the word germane to his or her?
Okay, I'll answer that question at the end. Okay. So, planning, implementation, meron pang isa. Meron kayong magkaiba yung coordination word. No? Iba yung implementing, ito yung sinasabi, coordinates with other dioceses. Coordination work, yun. Diba? So, iba yan. Iba yung coordination work. So, coordinating, no? Meron din kasi kayong mga coordinating function. Kasi yung coordinating is not necessarily implementing a program. Mamaya, this is actually coordinating. This is now related to networking and linkage, which I will talk about at the end of my session. So, coordination.
Is coordinating the same as a linkage?
Mamaya, we talk about that, yes. Coordinating. Or for example, when you talk about, ano ba yung part ng coordination function that you can possibly do? Hindi, yung mga coordinating function, pwede yung mga dioceses. Pwede yung coordinating. So, ibang trabaho yun. The other one is, ito naman yung, sabi ko nga kanina, to all those that are administrative Oh, administrative in nature. Hindi at what is administrative? Give me a sample of a function of a director that is administrative in nature. Assess the performance of all that's administrative.
Hiring and firing.
Hiring and
approving.
Pwede ano yun, you, when you hire, if you are the ones hiring. A committee of one, no? Hire. You, if you look at that one in a very, sabi ko na, yung hiring requirement ng admin approach, no? So, it can be admin. Ano pa yung isang administrative? Attends meeting. Diba, yung attend, diba, DOM nga kayo, died of meetings, diba? DOM na, yung mga, bayo marami tayo, DOM, kasi we died of meeting, puro meeting na lang, every, parang, pag-administrator ka, diba, most of your time is really spent on what meetings. That's why before the problems of the parish priest, before yung parish priest, pagka mayroong parochial school, siya pa rin yung director ng school. Kaya wala na siyang oras dun sa parokya kasi nauubos na ng kami meeting. Kasi lahat ng magulang sa kanya na nagko-complain. Eh, parishioner din yun. Meron ka. So that's what I'm talking about. You but that's an initiative, part of your work. So you specify, attends, meet, anong meeting, lahat ng classic meeting. Para nandun, staff meeting, iba pa yung staff meeting, iba pa yung diocesan meeting, iba pa yung, di ba? But that's administrative. Okay. So what I'm simply saying, to make it clear, you have to cluster your specific duties. Put them together. So kung lahat planning, planning muna. Kung lahat implementing, implementing muna. Mang tatanong, kailangan ko bang lagyan ng planning. Mas maganda kung yung clustering nyo ay naka-label. So that's easier to identify. Are we clear?
Yes.
In fact, when you do the actual, mas maganda rin nakalagay yung time frame, let's say monthly. Pag sinabi mo, attends the archdiocese, let's say the vicariate meeting monthly. So alam mo na monthly yung trabaho yun. Diba? Or attends, kunwari, weekly. Mas maganda if the frequency of the function is also stated in that particular function. Okay. So at the end, ito na yung tinatanong ni Sister Karen, tanong niya, pwede po ba? At the end, normally a job description, what will you see? You will see
the term of office.
Performs, then nakalagay ng performs, other duties that are germane to the functions. Diba? Meron ganun. Performs other duties that may be assigned that are germane. Ayun ang ano, germane or inherent. Ito ang legally pwede. Meaning, kasi minsan inuutusan mo yung ano, wala namang kinalaman, bumili ka nga ng copy dun. Kaya, pupunta ka nga kay sister, hindi mo yung regalo na ibibigay niya sa akin. Dahil pare ka, tsaka madre ka, yes sister, yes father, hindi naman nagpupuntin, pero hindi rin germane to the factor. See? Kung talagang technical ka, at money na nakakalim, hindi talaga siya. That's what I'm calling, it's not also na yun. At least conscious ka, pero normally, hindi nga tayo, that's what I'm saying eh. Sa simba, I think in reality, am I not right? Hindi masyadong conscious pa ang mga staff natin sa gano'n. Kasi nga, iba yung tingin sa atin, no? We are looked at differently. Kung sa office yan, sa kumpanya, yan, aangal yan. Pero pag, lalo na kung may union yung company. Pero pag sa, yun nga sinasabi ko, kasi nga iba, that's why you have to be conscious about it. Whether you, what you are doing is really within. No, the bounds of the duties and responsibilities. Because the tendency will really be to abuse. That's why when you are asking, is it right? It is only right. Kasi nga, minsan, for legal purposes, actually, yan eh. Kaya yan nilalagay for legal purposes, just in case. Pero syempre, in reality naman, hindi naman, minsan, yung minsan lang, let's say, during the year, minsan mo na okay naman yun, eh, pero yung minsan mo, araw-araw, hindi na minsan yun, but it's not longer minsan, abuso. Oo, abuso. Because sometimes there are really work that are not expected during the year, kakaiba, nautusok, but it's still related to the function. Right? So, kaya yun, it's okay on the basis, yung other functions, on the basis that it's not frequent, and it is related to the overall function of the person. Are we clear?
Yes.
Okay. Makakatulong ba sa inyo to?
Yes.
Kaya pwedeng English, pwedeng Filipino, o pwede sa language sa probinsya ninyo, okay naman yun. As long as, ang importante ho, yung inyong staff, meron, kasi once you appoint them, you're obliged to give this to them. Dapat meron silang JD. Kapag nandiyan, ano ba yun? At magkano yung ibabayad nyo sa... Ito, di ba kasi nahihiyak magkano, di ba? Hindi, so alam nyo na, in that case, you can tell them how much they will be compensated for this. Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, just before we move on to the other elements, who decides the job design or the job description? Is it the person being assigned the task or the HR themselves?
Ah, okay. Technically, kung organization to na may HR, syempre HR, no? Kasi function yun ng Human Resource Department. Pero ang simbahan kasi, in reality, wala naman kayong, hindi, I mean, technically, no? Wala naman talaga HR na separate because the structure of the church is not patterned after the private organizations. Okay. But normally, dun sa kundayosis ang pinag-uusapan natin, there is someone assigned by the bishop to do the HR function. Diba? Meron. So yung HR function na yun, when you say design, you do not design it on your own. You design it, actually, you just put it together. But when you do a work design, ganito yung may technical malbayad dito pag consultant kami, no? Ang ginagawa dyan, hindi basta na isulat yan. There is normally, na kung nari mag-uumpisa ka talaga from the start. You try to observe what is actually done. You look at the different documents. You interview yung boss, si Bishop, anong inaasahan. You interview yung mga ibang tao that are involved before you really finally come up. Tsaka hindi isa lang yan. Vis-a-vis other positions. Hindi naman isa lang yan na ginagawa mo. You do it in relation to all the positions that will be part of that particular office or unit. No? So, ulitin ko, kung may HR o may person that was mandated, commissioned, or lokoy ko sana ko date. So, kung inassign, no, who was assigned to do the work, siya yung gagawa, no? Hindi ang gumagawa, ako nga. Kasi wala pa kang tao in the first place. Mali nga yung ginagawa niya. Kasi i-assign kita maging director. Gawin mo kaya yung ano yung gusto mong gawin. Di ba? Which is wrong. I mean, that's how it was done before. Yes. Father, pupunta si Bishop, Father, I want to assign you to this since I have seen you and you have the future. You have, sasabihin lang sa you have the potential and I have seen God in you. Ganyan. And then, I want you to be, but can you just write your job description? Actually, mali yun. Dapat yung nag-hire, yung hiring person, may ready na kayong job description. Hindi yung hina-hire nyo ang gumagawa ng job description. That's wrong. Okay? Or for example, chancery. Kung, I mean, in the Archdiocese of Manila, medyo, mas ano na kami, sophisticated. So, may chancery, may HR doon. No? So, they're able to come up with standard job descriptions. Wala na kayong problema. But I'm just assuming, for example, ito naman hindi naman pangkatiketikal din. So let's say, kaya yung tip ko, yung skill dito, hindi naman pangkatiketikal lang, kahit ano yung imamanage nyo. So let's say, sa diocese nyo, sa simba, sa parokya nyo, gusto nyo magsimula, gusto nyo mag-add ng isang ministry dun sa West Tipan na ganun, may isa kayong gusto idagdag. Eh, dapat gawan nyo muna ng job description yun bago kayo mag-create ng mga tao o mag-hire. Kasi ito, i-hire mo, hindi basta ang gawin mo lang ganun. Malabo yung ganun. You are to be very specific with what should be done because you know what to expect at the end. That is important. Okay, so hindi yung taong hinahal. Dapat ginawa muna, either HR or whoever is the head of that particular unit. Are we clear? Okay.
Kung wala namang hinahal. Kung ay voluntary.
Hindi, when they say hire, okay. I'm using that in the context. Pag sinabi natin hire, whether may bayad o wala. Hinayin mo siya in that sense. No? Kinuha, in-appoint, they recruit, or whatever, we use a generic. Whoever you recruited, whether may bayad o hindi, dapat may job description, di ba? May gagawin. Oh, ngayon ang tanong, sino yung i-hire mo o re-recruit mo? Di ba? Pagka nakaplano ka na, meron pang isa, hindi ka makaka-recruit. Meron isang importante na kapatid nito. What is na kapatid? What is the sister of this?
Requirements.
Qualification.
Anong tawag doon?
Requirements.
Job
requirements.
Specification. Job spec. No? You need a job specification. Meaning, even all these functions, what is a job specification? Job specification means the minimum human qualities or competencies that are needed to perform the
duties.
Okay.
The office.
Again, take a look at minimum human qualities or competencies that are needed to perform the functions. Minimum lang, minimum. Meaning, let's say, minsan ang sinasabi mo, kunwari, director of category, ang minimum requirement, educational attainment, or then bishop. Siya sa akin ang minimum eh. Kahit pagka gano'n, I don't overqualify. Diba? Kaya nga sabi ko, minimum. Because you will notice, in like, pag overqualified ka, hindi ka nilalaga. Because it only needs this, so I don't need a doctorate degree holder to occupy the position. You are qualified educational attainment-wise. See? Parang you need a driver, tapos sabihin nyo, college graduate. Overqualified. Okay. Am I making sense?
Yes!
Oh. Ano ang mga job specification? Ano ang paggagalingan? Kailangan muna, you have to, okay, so for example, you need to specify educational attainment. Kailangan nyo ba high school graduate? Kailangan nyo ba elementary, vocational? Or maybe you need a particular college graduate and a particular course, no? Sasabihin niya, magkaiba to. Tsaka yung user, you will say, let's say you are hiring a director kasi yung sample natin, no? So you will say, critical director, ano, for you, ganyan, ako na rin, nagre-recruit tayo ngayon. For you, what is the minimum educational attainment? Okay, you think necessary to perform all those functions that we mentioned? The educational attainment. Elementary, high school, college, doctorate. College graduate. Do you have a preference for a particular discipline?
Language.
Language spoken.
Hindi educational attainment. Mamaya, magkaiba to. Iba ang iba tong training. Magkaiba yan. Iba to, ha? Iba yan. Iba yan. Bayang experience. Magkakaiba to. Educational attainment pa lang pinag-usapan. Huwag yung pagsasama-sama.
Major management.
Preferable. Magkaiba kasi mas.
Religious education.
Religious
education. So you are saying, ano, at least college graduate with a degree
in religious education.
Religious education, theology. Okay, so very clear kayo. Am I clear?
Yes.
Bakit theology? Bakit? Kasi merong kinalaman dito. Pwede nyo sabihin eh. Kasi pwede namang merong ginagamit. Should or preferably. Pag kasi pag preferably, it's a soft requirement. Pag sinabi yung should, it's a or a must. Meaning, it's not non-negotiable.
Three, ano?
You have to use your
SD card. Are you going to use card?
Preferably or mask or should?
Nakakailang ka ng SD card.
Nasa inyo na ngayong ano yan.
Kasi depende rin.
Kaya nakalimutan ko lang.
Iba yung degree. Meron kasi kayong, for example, I am a college graduate major in education. Pwede ba akong mag-apply? Pwede. Kung wala kayong nilagay education, sabi niyo, religious education at saka theology. But you did not say, yung iba, this is what I'm saying. Once you specify in the job specification the limits, yung ibang applicants out kagad. Doon pa lang sa education. Kasi you already specified that the education needed is someone with a degree in religious education or theology. So anybody, kasi sabi niyo must. Pero for example, nilagay niyo, preferably, magkaiba yan. Pero pag sinabi niyo preferably, so it means other majors you can consider. Yan, yun ang ibig sabihin lang. Okay, yes ma'am.
Ang question lang kasi, referring to police director.
We are following this example. We are recruiting. Wala ko sa inyo mga recruiting. Baka kahit sino sa inyo, walang qualified. We are recruiting for a catechetical director. Ito example natin. So when I ask you, what is the educational attainment you think is needed to perform the function? Sabi niyo, preferably lang. Preferably, graduate with major in religious education or theology. Sabi niyo gano'n. Yun ang sabi niyo, preferably lang. Yun ang kanina.
Wala eh. Tayo, we're just being assigned.
Kasi,
diba? We are just being appointed. Diba? Wala ka namang choice. Tapos, pati sila as coordinators, diba? They're just being assigned. Diba? So siguro ano?
Okay, teka muna. Education lang muna.
Hindi yung education. Siguro, mas maganda pag-usapan. Yung catechism mismo. Not the director, not the coordinator.
Kasi kaya isip niyo yung present niyo, you can think in terms of actual.
Wala ka namang ano.
Kasi pwede namang lay it. Yeah. Diba? Kasi ang context niyo, kasi po pare, hindi ba pwedeng lay? Kasi that's why you have to, that's why I'm presenting to you other ways. Kasi pag sinabi, kasi ito po kami ngayon, what in the future? Diba? Kaya sinasabi natin, hindi, mamaya natin pupuntahan yun. Pero ang sinasabi ko, in general, considering what is the church now, kumukonte ang pare, kumukonte ang madre, are we not open? Kaya nga tinatanong ko kasi catechetical director. Unless meron talagang rule ang church ngayon, iba naman yon. Pagka sinabi na kasing ang ano dito, rule ng church ay priest, iba na yon. Hindi, may education, pero nakalagay na kasi priest. So it means out ng lahat. Diba? Parang gano'n ang pinag-uusapan natin. But I'm simply talking about exercise in the context, kunwari open.
So dapat maliwala?
Open. Oo. Kasi dapat open eh. Kasi if I give that example, hindi na kayo makaka-recruit. Parang kasi we can change this to a catechetical director or coordinator. O kaya, catechetical volunteer. Dalagyan natin ito. Hindi, mag-iiba yun. Yung process, you are to specify the educational attainment. Okay? Are we clear? Sisya na ano ko po yun. Ang ano ko lang, kailangan very clear kayo kung meron kayong educational attainment na kailangan. Kasi it's possible. For example, we are recruiting for a catechist volunteer. Kailangan ba yun?
Yes.
Kailangan ba college graduate? Kailangan ba na? Di mag-iiba. What I'm saying, mag-iiba ang educational attainment mo. Kasi iba na yung position na nare-record mo. So, ganun lang yung gagawin nyo. Mag-iibahin nyo yung degree kasi dito, will be dependent on this. Siyempre, mas simple yung ginagawa. Hindi naman kailangan mataas yung educational attainment. That's why I said, if part of what you need to recruit is a driver, hindi mo kailangan. Kasi kung driver description to, ang educational attainment, hindi college graduate, di ba? Okay. So, for example, training, meron bang kailangan na training? Can anybody be considered as a director? Balik tayo doon. Meron ba, kunwari, sabihin nyo, at least 1 year, kunwari, 1 year, kunwari, training. In catechetical ministry, meron siyang 1 year. May experience ba na kailangan? O, sabihin nyo ulit, at least 1 year experience in ganito, community involved. Nilalagay nyo na may one. Diba? One, or at least two. Depende kung ano yung... Or, ma'am, pwede po bang wala? If you don't need any training, di wala naman kayo ilalagay. Yun na, di ba? Lalagay nyo. No need for an experience. Okay. Ngayon, kung there is a position, as I've said, na required that it should be a priest by... Kasi by appointment, hindi nakalagay parish priest na talaga. So it means it's not, that position is not open to lay people. Okay naman yun, as long as you specify. Okay. So other than this, hindi pa tapos yun. Educational training experience. Ano pa? Okay. So dapat meron kayong minimum skills that you should be looking for. So, let's say, lahat pare, kunwari lang. Let's follow that logic that qualified lahat ng priests. But among all the priests who are in, what are the minimum skills that, okay, kunwari, ang isang skill ay related to oral and written communication. Sasabihin nyo, above average oral, above average oral and written communication skill. Tingnan nyo to, AA, above average.
Missing personality.
That's the most, that's important.
Eh, wala tayong marirecruit dito.
From Pagum.
Mr. Take a look at this. Misan kasi, kasi ba hindi tayo scientific about doing this, that's why you have to be scientific. My question is, can you measure above that? Yes. There is a psychometric way of determining the level of skill. It can be below average, average, above average, superior. I'm just talking about above average. So it can be measured. Hindi pwedeng yung, for example, okay, yung example, pleasing person. How do you determine a pleasing person?
Inside
and outside. That is very subjective. Pero pag sinabi mo ganito, hindi kaya sabi ko, kailangan measurable. In the recruitment in HR, it has to be measurable. For example, ang nami sa isip ni Sister Pleasing, pero pag pleasing, how do you measure pleasing? Sabi mo, brown eyes, high nose, no hair. Organization, even the physical attributes are necessary. No? For example, pagka, I don't know if you are aware of this, but if you are applying as a flight attendant, the minimum, ang marami rin, kaya kayo madumi, hindi kayo pwede. Kaya, ang Diyos, pag-andre kayo, kaya kayo flight attendant. Kasi ang minimum height requirement is 5'4". So, nakalagay talaga yung sa physical attribute, at least 5'4". Ano ang logic doon? Because part of their job description is to help the passenger to put that luggage in the bin. Because I'm so sorry, I cannot reach it, please. Okay. So that's what I'm saying.
aspect. Sir, meron pang requirement, no? For example, sometimes you ask, military. For example, sa military din, as the 5-5 ata ang requirement. Bakit? Because the arm that you carry, eh, kumalika pa mag-alaw. No? Kaya yung height, because of the reach. The height has something to do with the reach. No? Parang ganon. Kaya may logic yung hindi lahat pwedeng pleasing, no? Pleasing to that. Pero sa, in the eyes of God, we are all pleasing. Diba? Okay, so, malinaw ba tayo?
Yes!
Tawa kayo ng tawa, kaya you have to be concrete about that pleasing that you talk about. Yes.
There are many graduates now in the criminology. Impossible. But the height is 5'2", 5'3", na hindi sila nakapasok sa sa police o mayroon akong parokyan na beautiful pero bubo lang.
Bubo lang.
So, dun yung discrimination na tinatawag. Kasi you discriminate, meaning you really select among those based on the standards. Okay na tayo dun sa...
Yes.
Oh, ngayon, naintindihan po yung skill. Meron pang sample ng skill. Kasi ito, communication, yung isa kasing skill that is necessary na ngayon ay yung computer skill na so yung isa ngayon is technology na information IT skill depende na ngayon yung IT skill na related kunwari minsan i-specify na halimbawa average knowledge and skill sabi mo Word and Excel lalagay mo na kasi mame-measure naman yun eh kung bibigyan mo ng test no. So at least average or misan kasi director naman sa familiarity na lang. Familiarity with Word and Excel. Familiar, di ba sinasabi can use ano? Familiar, kilala mo na. Di ba? Kilala mo na. Di ba sinabi ginagamit eh. Hindi, director naman yung nahanap mo eh. Hindi naman typist, di ba? Because if you are hiring for a typist, ang nahanap mo, yung score sa IT will be higher. So, let's say, above average skill in Word and Excel.
And 30 words per minute.
Hindi na ngayon uso yung 30 words. Naalatali lang. Typing pa yun. So, are we clear on the skills? Kung ano mo yung related dito, i-specify nyo lang. Hindi naman kailangan marami. So, normally, the oral and written is necessary. Number two, yung inherent technical skill necessary to perform the job. Yun lang naman yung, hindi naman kasi baka ito, you have a laundry list. Napakahaba na, wala na kayong ma-recruit. No? Kaya namin tapos yung isa na hinahanap, syempre meron, naghahanap kayo ng ano, merong attitude. Attitude or hindi, kasi naghahanap kayo nito. Attitude or trait, quality, na personal quality. Meron kayong isang hinahanap na personal or leadership. Ah. Leadership o kaya yung personal trait, no? Quality. Lagi namang ano yan eh, kahit saan. No, for example, say ba sa'yo, honest, committed. Meron, kasi yung iba mame-measure mo talaga eh. No? yung mga ganun. Kasi sa psychological test na may measure naman yan, for example, kaya nata mo, easy to get along with. Yan. Ganun. Qualities, yung personal na pang-misang social skill ang hinahanap mo, no? Ability to relate with other people. Na may measure naman yan psychologically. Of course. Yung iba, kasi efficient, referral, kasi mag-check mo na, there are many ways by which you can validate yung gusto mo na, no? Pag nag-a-apply sila. Ang suggestion ko lang, huwag niyo masyadong dalamihan kasi baka wala kayong ma-record. Yun lang, oh, walang mag-a-apply. So, okay na tayo. So, ganito ha, lagi pong magkasama ang job spec at saka job description. Mauuna munang ginagawa yung job description and then you write the job specification. Tapos, scientifically din, when you do that in the company, mas maraming trabaho, syempre mas mataas yung compensation. Ganun yun. Ang basis kasi nito, nitong compensation, nandito na tayo. Yung sa hirap ng trabaho na ginagawa niya dito. No? So, so, dito, sometimes, there is such a thing as, pagka kasi yung technique kanin, nandun na kayo sa compensation, di kini-recruit mo yung mga tao. So, dito, recruitment selection, you recruit on the basis of what you need. No? So, you have many ways by which you can recruit and select people. You can by an common referral, di ba? May parishioner kayo, may kilala, di ba? Mission ganon. Kung director, syempre, it's at the, sa priest level, kung puro pare o sa madre, di referral system naman yun, di ba? So, the other way is by which you really open the recruitment, kung allowed, no? You can post it online, pwede nilagay nyo sa dyaryo, dun sa parish, di ba? Yung opening, pero naglalagay kayo doon. Pwede naman. So, there are many ways by which you can recruit and then you interview people. Diba? There are various ways. And then, what happens, you do training. And, for example lang, isang meron kayong requirements sa training. But among all the applicants, walang meron. Nobody is meeting that training requirement, but you need to fill up the position. So, sometimes what you will do is to weigh that particular requirement and choose among those applicants who is the best even without that training requirement. And what you will do, that's why there is a training there in many companies, what you do is you train them prior to the appointment. So, there is such a thing, for example, sa mga call center, ang tawag doon, boarding, no? So, onboarding training, tinatawag nila. So, mag-training muna sila before they become call center agents. Yun. Pwede rin mangyari yun. So, you can do the training. One is prior to the appointment. Tapos yung isa namang klase ng training, yung ongoing training, di ba? Kamukha nito, yung, I think yung part ng ginagawa dito, kung ano na kayo, this is part of your continuing development. Ang tawag namin dito, continuing development program. Okay? So it means, kasi yung ano, the kind of work that you do from time to time, yung kahit naman pare at madre, nagbabasa din, di ba? Ongoing, other than reading the Bible, but other readings that are related to your function, to your work, to your mandate, di ba? Nagbabasa ka naman ongoing naman yun eh. Sa akin, a very concrete example, as a parish priest, for example, to make a meaningful homily every Sunday. Kasi yun yung talagang, I think, yun yung isang work na talagang for a priest and for me to see. Talagang pag nag-prepare ka, nagbabasa ka talaga, no? Hindi yung every Sunday, ano nang seminarista ako. Father, parang nakwento mo na kahit nung isa lang. Pero talagang pagkatanda ka. Hindi, di ba seriously speaking?
Yes, yes.
Di ba?
Yes.
That's why it's a, training. Di ba? I also know that there is a 3-unit, 6-unit course on how to prepare homily. Di ba? Sorry, oo. The training itself, but it's ongoing. Training also, sometimes you're not able. Yung beginning, makikita nyo naman din siguro kayo when you started, you are not that good in delivering your homily, but now you're better. Kasi you see people, you train, you speak better now, you're more confident, you have more experience. Kasi lahat yun is part of that training and development. Ano po yung mahalaga? Kasi sa catechetical ministry, yan yung importante kasi yung marami kang makukuhang volunteer, pero wala pa nun talagang theoretical, I mean foundations, no? And even that level of what? The level of spirituality, kasi iba naman yung ginagawa mo eh. Hindi naman yung simpleng nagbebenta ka ng produkto, di ba? That's why even the person has to be developed or deepen your spirituality for you really to go on and help in the ministry. Kasi ako naman yung as a director, iba yung ano nun, kasi yan talaga administrative eh. Unless bumababa ka sa baba, really to help in the implementation of the programs, magkaiba yun. Diba? Depende nga sa yung sa nature ng diocese nyo, how many are you, ilan ang mga tao. Pero yung training and development is something that the church should really invest on. Especially sa volunteers. Di ba yan ang karamihan problema? Walang funds ang catechetical ministry. Yung second collection, lagi pang second ministry. Ang kaling collection, 100, gano'n. E bago ka makapag-send ng isang volunteer to send to a yung catechetical, ang tagal-tagal nun, diba? Isang taon, dalawang taon. Yes. Eh, in the meantime, wala naman trabaho yung volunteer. Kailangan may allowance. May ano rin, diba? That's what I'm talking about in terms of a continuing development.